Man, the feeling to be on PBS, you have no idea how incredibly important it is to all of us because it was 5 years of a lot of work. It's not that we just got together and say, hey, you know what, let's put together a show. No. It was something that was cultivated since the first day that I had the idea and that I was doing this show in Miami. And then I did the Kickstarter campaign and everything happened for a reason. The quality that goes in the PBS productions is something that I've always admired. And it's always been a dream of mine. I really didn't think it was gonna happen so soon, and in particular with this project, but Michael's music is gonna live forever, and it impacted so many people. So God chose that it was this project to give me the opportunity to show the world what it is that came from all of our hearts.
His music is so powerful and has special meaning to me. And in this situation, it's a unique collaboration of Michael's music and Latin music, and I've always loved Latin music.
Man, how do we feel about sharing the stage with all these great artists? It's surreal.
Definitely a dream.
For me, I'm excited to be sharing the stage with all those people, but with this one, it's my special one. Super excited to be sharing the stage with Jen, you know. No, it's exciting because I love, you know, I'm a huge fan of my wife's music.
I think that's what's special about every time we do it live, because like you get your own inspiration every time, and it's new every time.
Yeah, there's an element of sensitivity, and that's important because you do have to pick up those colors that deal with being really, really careful with not overpowering the song, especially in a tropical Latin setting. I thought I heard you cry, asking me to
come and hold you in my arms. Having the dual job of producing and also performing in this special was definitely intense. My brain was half production side, half artist and creative. I was like thinking about the production element, the recording, and then I was just thinking, oh my God, I gotta perform perfect because this is my one shot. This is it. What we play right now is staying forever. But once the bass line came in, my brain just went whoop, and it just was like a samurai, devoted to performing and to giving the best show of my life.
I'm just extremely happy, I mean, of all the hard work he's put in, for him believing in us, the artist, all the musicians. Tony's somebody that when those doors go shut, you can't ever tell, because he just always kept a positive outlook, and we saw the bigger picture at the end, and we're now living this bigger picture.
I've never heard these kind of arrangements for his songs ever. When people hear this, they're just gonna flip out. I can't wait for even the people that have worked with Michael on all of these songs in the studio, Quincy, all the people that have written with him as well. When they hear these arrangements, I think they're just gonna, I'm not gonna be able to touch you. I'm gonna touch you now.
No way.
I won't be able to get close to you. It's like.
We had never really performed all of us together. You know, this was the first time Judith Hill was on board, Sheila E. It was the first time we were all coming together to celebrate the music from this album. All these emotions, you know, and that's why at the end of the show, I just broke down because it was so much work and your whole heart and going through all these obstacles and people closing the door on you. So all those memories started like flashing in my head before I grabbed that mic to say thank you to everybody on board. Not only the musicians and the talent, but everybody that ever believed in me. In all the Kickstarter backers from the beginning. It all came together into this one show, and it wasn't only about the music, but it was about the emotion of everybody put together and about just celebrating what we were able to accomplish as a team.